like to brief the honorable members on the outbreak of novel coronavirus disease in China and some other countries and the actions taken by the government of India. Sir, coronaviruses are large group of viruses that cause illness in humans and animals. Rarely animal coronavirus can evolve and infect people and then spread between people, such as has been seen with severe acute respiratory syndrome, SARS in 2003, and Middle East respiratory syndrome, MERS in 2014. China reported an outbreak of novel coronavirus on 31st December 2019. The outbreak was initially noticed in a seafood market in Wuhan city in Hubei province of China in early December 2019 and in a short span has spread to all the provinces of China. As on 6th Feb, sir, I have slightly updated the data as on today because the statement that has been circulated may have the data till yesterday night. So as on 6th Feb, a total of 31,161 confirmed cases and 636 deaths have been reported in China. A total of 275 confirmed cases have been reported outside China from 27 countries, including Hong Kong, Macau, and Taiwan. The number of cases and deaths reported from China is showing an upward trend. World Health Organization has declared this outbreak as a public health emergency of international concern on 30th January 2020. Many of the epidemiological parameters such as incubation period, mode of transmission, subclinical infection, period of virus shedding, etc., are still being researched. Once a person is exposed to the infection, it may take about 2 weeks to develop the illness. The main symptoms of novel coronavirus are fever, cough, and difficulty in breathing. There will be radiological evidence indicative of pneumonia. In 10 to 20% of cases, disease may become severe enough to require ventilatory support. The case fatality is around 2%. Human-to-human transmission has been noticed in the cases of novel coronavirus, which is called as 2019 nCoV, that's the abbreviated form, and it spreads through droplets and aerosols in persons having close contact. Public health implications of the reports that the virus has been found in fecal samples of infected patients are being worked out. All suspected or probable cases of nCoV must be treated in isolation with barrier nursing and universal precautions to prevent the further spread of disease. In our country, 3 positive cases have been reported so far from Kerala. All these cases have travel history from Wuhan in China. They have been isolated and are reported to be clinically stable. The ever-increasing magnitude of this outbreak calls for a concerted action by not only health, but all sectors of government. Government of India has initiated a series of actions to prevent entry of the disease and to contain it. I am daily reviewing the situation. A group of ministers consisting of Minister of External Affairs, Minister of Civil Aviation, and Minister of State for Home Affairs, Minister of State for Shipping, and Minister of State for Health and Family Welfare, chaired by me, has been constituted to monitor the situation. Cabinet Secretary has taken daily reviews with all related ministries of Health, Defence, Ministry of External Affairs, Civil Aviation, Home, Textiles, Pharma, Commerce, and other officials, including with state chief secretaries. My own ministry is constantly reviewing the evolving scenario. Video conferences is being held with states every other day. The Government of India has also taken several other measures to control the risk of novel coronavirus infection spreading to India. First advisory was used on 17th of January 2020, and as the situation is evolving, the travel advisories are accordingly getting revised. Presently, existing visas, including e-visas already issued, are no longer valid for any foreign national traveling from China. People have already been advised to refrain from travel to China through an earlier advisory. People traveling to China henceforth shall be quarantined on return. People having compelling reasons to visit India are asked to contact the India Embassy in Beijing or consulate in Shanghai or Guangzhou. Screening of passengers was initiated since 18th of January 2020. Initially, airports at Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, Kolkata, Bengaluru, Hyderabad and Kochi were covered and subsequently expanded in a total of 21 airports. Universal thermal screening has been made mandatory for all flights from Singapore and Thailand besides Hong Kong and China, and these flights will park at earmarked aero bridges to facilitate screening. Signages have been displayed at prominent places in airports and ports. In-flight announcements are being made and self-declaration forms are being filled up by all the passengers. As of today, a total of 1,275 flights have been screened, covering a total of 1,39,539 passengers, and 150 passengers identified with symptoms have been referred to isolation facilities. Teams of specialist doctors were sent to all the airports to ensure effective screening and arrangement for isolation in the attached hospitals. Screening of passengers has also been initiated in 12 major seaports and all minor ports of the country to identify passengers and crew coming from China and to isolate them in case they are found symptomatic. In view of a confirmed case in Nepal, Government of India has initiated screening in all integrated checkposts from Nepal in collaboration with states of UP, Uttarakhand, West Bengal, Sikkim and Bihar, and Seema Shastra Bal and Land Port authorities. Gram Sabhas have been conducted in villages adjoining the borders with Nepal to create awareness amongst people about the disease and precautions to be taken in collaboration with Panchayati Raj Ministry. In view of the continuing lockdown of the Hubei province in China, the Government of India decided to evacuate the Indian students and other professionals working in Wuhan and neighboring cities in the Hubei province. In a coordinated operation with Ministry of Civil Aviation, Air India, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, two special Air India flights were operated between Delhi and Wuhan on 31st January and 1st February 2020 that brought back a total of 654 passengers that included 647 Indian citizens, including two Indian embassy officials who were on the ground in Wuhan to coordinate the evacuation operation, and seven Maldivian nationals. I take this opportunity to thank Air India, its crew, and our team of doctors and paramedical staff who executed this challenging operation and place on record the appreciation on behalf of this august house for their contribution. After evacuation, the people are presently undergoing quarantine at special facilities created by the Indian Army in Manesar and by Indo-Tibetan Border Police in Chawla camp. 10 of the evacuees who were symptomatic have been shifted to isolation. All of them have tested negative for this disease and are stable. All other evacuees are being medically examined on daily basis and are healthy. The Indian embassy and consulates are also in regular contact with the Indian community in other parts of China and is keeping a constant track of their well-being. Regular surveillance has been initiated across the country for all cases having travel history from China and for people having contact with such persons and having fever, cough, or breathlessness. Through integrated disease surveillance network, all such persons are tracked, and presently we are following 6,599 passengers across 29 states and union territories in the community. The state surveillance officers, district surveillance officers, and rapid response teams of health professionals under the leadership of state health secretaries are monitoring all such people on a daily basis. Sufficient isolation beds have been made available in the tertiary facilities across the country to manage any outbreak. 305 symptomatic travelers have been referred to isolation facility and are being monitored. Ministry has issued guidelines to support states on surveillance and contact tracing. Surveillance at points of entry, laboratory samples collection, packaging and transport, clinical management protocol, and infection prevention and control in healthcare facilities. To ensure availability of critical items like personal protective equipments and N95 masks, the exports of the same were also prohibited by Director General of Foreign Trade. A buffer stock of personal protective equipments and N95 masks is maintained by states as well as by the Union Government. National Institute of Virology, Pune is the nodal laboratory. As part of ICMR's preparedness for emerging and re-emerging infectious diseases, NIV Pune has established capacity for molecular diagnosis of novel coronavirus. Next generation sequencing is also established. Testing of clinical samples has also been initiated in 11 more laboratories in the country. As of now, 1,305 samples have been tested and 1,282 samples were found negative. 20 samples are under process and 3 samples have tested positive. Risk communication material has been prepared and is widely disseminated even in regional languages through states. Required awareness in community is ensured through technical briefings by experts in radio and television. Daily press briefing is being held by the Ministry of Health and information is being shared through social media. A 20/7 control room is operational where the number is 011-2397-8046. Government of India is in regular touch with the World Health Organization's headquarters in Geneva, regional office in New Delhi, and also the country office to get updates on the evolving scenario outside India. Government of India has also provided support to other countries in tackling the challenge posed by the 2019 nCoV disease. ICMR has offered to do testing of samples for other Southeast Asian region countries. Testing of samples from Maldives has already been undertaken. request from Afghanistan for samples testing has been agreed to. We have agreed to provide technical assistance to Bhutan in managing this infectious disease and screening of passengers also. Government of India is constantly monitoring the situation and is taking all necessary steps to avoid the spread of the novel corona disease. Thank you, sir.
Subscribe kar lijiye hamara YouTube channel The Front aur bell icon dabakar notification zarur lijiye.